Who's made a difference in your life?
Oh, a lot of people. But a lot of people who have allowed me to have some silence. And I don't think we give that gift very much anymore. I'm very concerned that our society is much more interested in information than wonder, in noise rather than silence. How do we do that? I mean, in our business, yours and mine, how do we encourage reflection? I trust that this book will do some of that, but oh my, this is a noisy world.
Now, Mr. Rogers is certainly one of the best things that's ever happened to public television, and his Peabody Award is testament to that fact. We in public television are proud of Fred Rogers, and I'm proud to present Mr. Rogers to you now.
Fred. All right, Rogers, you got the floor.
This is what I give. I give an expression of care every day to each child to help him realize that he is unique. I end the program by saying, you've made this day a special day by just your being you. There's no person in the whole world like you, and I like you just the way you are. And I feel that if we in public television can only make it clear that feelings are mentionable and manageable, we will have done a great service for mental health. I think that it's much more dramatic that two men could be working out their feelings of anger, much more dramatic than showing something of gunfire.
You narrate it?
I'm the host, yes. And I do all the puppets, and I write all the music, and I write all the scripts.
Well, I'm supposed to be a pretty tough guy, and this is the first time I've had goosebumps for the last 2 days.
Could I tell you the words of one of the songs which I feel is very important?
Yes.
This has to do with that good feeling of control, which I feel that children need to know is there. And it starts out, what do you do with the mad that you feel? And that first line came straight from a child. I work with children, doing puppets in very personal communication with small groups. What do you do with the mad that you feel when you feel so mad you could bite? When the whole wide world seems oh so wrong and nothing you do seems very right? What do you do? Do you punch a bag? Do you pound some clay or some dough? Do you round up friends for a game of tag or see how fast you go? It's great to be able to stop when you've planned a thing that's wrong and be able to do something else instead and think this song. I can stop when I want to, can stop when I wish, can stop, stop, stop anytime. And what a good feeling to feel like this and know that the feeling is really mine. Know that there's something deep inside that helps us become what we can. For a girl can be someday a lady, and a boy can be someday a man.
I think it's wonderful. I think it's wonderful. Looks like you just earned the $20 million.
How many kids do you think are out there who in 30 years you've influenced, who you've made a difference in and made them feel something special?
I don't care how many, even if it's just one. We get so wrapped up in numbers in our society, and the most important thing is that we're able to be one-to-one, you and I, with each other at the moment. If we can be present to the moment with the person that we happen to be with at the moment, that's what's important. It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling. You're growing inside, and when you wake up ready to say, I think I'll make a snappy new day. It's such a good feeling, a very good feeling, the feeling you know that I'll be back when the day is new, and I'll have more ideas for you, and you'll have things you'll want to talk about. I will too. You always make each day such a special day. You know how, by just your being yourself. I'll be back next time. Bye-bye.
Well, I know that when I walk out of the studio someday and there is a child who has Down syndrome,
right,
for instance, and that child comes up and gives me a hug, I know that that's the field that I want to be growing in, because I see that people who are not the fancy people in this world are the ones who seem to nourish my soul. And I want to learn how to be the best receiver that I can ever be, because I think graceful receiving is one of the most wonderful gifts we can give anybody. If we receive what somebody gives us in a graceful way, we've given that person, I think, a wonderful gift.
This is my friend Jeff Erlinger. He's one of my neighbors here, and I asked him if he would come by today. I'd like to sing that to you and with you.
Okay, sure.
It's you I like. It's not the things you wear. It's not the way you do your hair. But it's you I like. The way you are right now. The way down deep inside you. Not the things that I do. Not your fancy chair. That's just beside you.
I just read something I think came from you. It's you I like, every part of you, your skin, your eyes, your feelings. Whether old or new, I hope you'll remember, even when you're feeling blue, that it's you I like. It's you yourself. It's you I like.
It helps to be loved in order to work in this life.
Please welcome Jeffrey Erlinger.
It is.
I'm so glad to see you.
Oh, thank you for coming.
My pleasure.
Oh. What a surprise.
It's an honor to be here tonight, to be part of your proud this proud moment. You know, when you tell people that it's you I like, we know that you really mean it. And tonight, I want to let you know that on behalf of millions of children and grown-ups, it is you that I like.
It's about what, in the end?
It's about being. It's about the things that matter to me.
Yeah.
It's about the white spaces between the paragraphs, which I think are more important than any of the text,
yeah,
because it allows you to think about what's just been said. I had a professor one time, I think he's on page 20 or 22. His name was Dr. William Orr.
Right.
And he said, you know, Fred, there's one thing that evil cannot stand, and that is forgiveness. And you notice the rest of the page is blank.
Yes.
It needs a lot of time to think about that.